your MC for tonight. Nice to meet all of you. Welcome to Penang, and welcome to Penang Club. Selamat datang, which means welcome in Malay. Right? So, how are y'all? Good? Excited for tonight?
Could be better.
Could be better. Do you enjoy Penang? Good? Like Penang?
Love it.
Okay. So, for now, okay, without further ado, I would like to invite Mr. Joe to give a speech. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a round of applause.
First of all, I'd like to welcome all fellow Concordians, and some of them flying very far away to come here. Thank you very much. And also, I'd like to thank you very much for Mr. Morris, Mr. and Mrs. Hawkins, also come all the way from UK to attend our Penang reunion. Thank you very much. This is just to welcome everybody, so I'm not supposed to be here to give a speech. But, well, first, tonight, two persons will need to have a speech. That's Mr. Morris and Mr. Hawkins. So first, I would like to invite Mr. Hawkins, Mr. Morris to speak to everybody.
Yeah, yes.
Two weeks ago, I had to make a speech to my Rotary Club, and halfway through, I forgot what I was going to say. It's a sign of getting old, you see. 74 this year. So Mr. Phillips, who many of you remember, still has a very clear mind, and he's 91.
Wow.
But you know that Mrs. Paul died, I'm sure you knew that. And the other evening, I was joking with Max, and we were laughing a lot, and then we talked about the teachers at Concord, and in particular, his memories of Mrs. Paul, and Max started to cry. So, he was very emotional. But 10 minutes later, he was back laughing and... It's wonderful to see so many of us here tonight, from all over the world. It's nice that our reunions are supported so well. I mean, we've done Hong Kong and China, we've done Bahrain and Dubai. We had one in England in Tunbridge Wells, which I couldn't attend. I forced my wife to attend it, but I was lying on the hospital operating slab, so I couldn't go. The next big reunion is going to be at Concord in August 2019, when we will be celebrating 70 years of the college. You are all invited to come. Mr. Hawkins may have more to say about this.
I wrote.
And don't worry that you have to sleep in the cubicles with the curtain across the door, because we now have very, very high quality bedrooms. Single rooms for almost all the students, and air conditioning. So, you see, it's a luxury job now.
Can we redo our year levels?
You can come back and re-sign.
How is Westwind now?
Sorry, William?
So, how is Westwind now?
West Wing. The West Wing has been turned into classrooms.
Oh.
I joined Concord in 1965, but there is an old student here tonight, Jim, who joined in 1955. I always wanted Concord to be among the top schools in Britain. Somewhere which would not only get the top students into wonderful universities and medical schools, but somewhere that you would be proud of, that you would say, I went to Concord College. I was one of the privileged ones.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah.
And I also wanted you to send your children to us. In the early days, before we made the big improvements in the buildings and things, and a large number of our students, old students, wouldn't send their kids to the college because they thought they were still in the cubicles with curtains. But I know fathers like to impose misery on their sons and say, I had to put up with it, now you have to put up with it.
Referring to Casey.
I'm pleased to say that my dream is now coming true.
Oh, yes.
We are usually in the top five for A-level results in the whole of the UK. And this year, well, the year that's just finished, we were number two. Whoa. If you only look at the maths and science results, which have always been the strength of the college. Of course, in the days of people like Alan Wong, I had to teach A-level economics, maths, and history all in one year. I used to come home in the night and my wife would say, oh, somebody in the office has invited us out. And I'd say, you know I can't go out until the weekend, because I was preparing like mad to see these horrible monsters like The improvement in the college began in the late 80s. We have here people like Lim Chi Kang, and we were discussing this the other night with someone else, and then the results started to really soar. Very, very good students. I remember that year we sent 9 students to the LSE, which was a record for us. But we need to keep clapping. We found that Mr. Bell's decision to turn the college into a charitable trust released large sums of money for us to put up new buildings. I think it was Casey Tan who was saying about the student kitchen where they can cook and eat together up in the garden. Buildings like that became possible because as a charitable trust, we stopped paying tax, and the money that we would have handed over to the government could be ploughed back into investment in the college. In fact, Mr. Bell, before he created the charitable trust, was paying, and it's hard to believe it now, 98% marginal rate of tax on the college surplus. 98 pence in every pound was taken away. And that was because before the blessed Margaret Thatcher became Prime Minister, the top rate of tax on income from wages was 83%. But if your income came from dividends or interest, profits, there was a surcharge of 15%, which took the rate up to 98%. So you can see the decision to turn it into a trust was a wonderful thing for us. Then we recruited some outstanding students in 1999. We were celebrating then the 50th anniversary of the college, what we called the Jubilee Scholarship. And my wife and I went around British Council offices all over the place, and we left test papers behind in maths, in English, in IQ, and we were selecting the very best students to come to the college to celebrate the Golden Jubilee. And the arrangement was this. We asked the students to pay only 30% of the fees. If at the end of the A-level course they got 3 A's, then we refunded the 70%. So in fact they got a totally free place. And that really brought some marvelous students into the college. Their results were so good that we went climbing up the league table. And that's being sustained now. I hope that you will support the scholarship scheme which I introduced to many of you last year. It's going to be in my name, but the idea is we want to give places to students who are very bright but who come from families who are not so well off. Now already we've had large and small donations to this scholarship fund. I think over £300,000 is in so far, and the college is putting in £1.3 million. I'm hoping that we'll be able to do well with these students. I'm particularly proud of what the college has achieved since I retired in 2002. Things at the college are going very well indeed. Andy has done a splendid job in organizing the events. And I know that others in Penang have given him assistance, but I thought when I saw Andy this week that he looked like a troubled man with the weight of the world on his shoulders, hoping that things were going to turn out well. And if you've run out of money to pay for all these bills, Andy, I've got £10 for you. I've already mentioned Max to you. I was talking with Max and some of the other boys the other night, and we were laughing away, and I quoted a song from the 1950s. The song said, anything that gives you pleasure is either illegal, immoral, or it makes you fat. And I think in Isa Al-Wazan, where are you? Isa? Stand up. Isa's suddenly turned shy. I think in Isa we have the embodiment of the truth of the old song from the 1990s. Too much about Isa that's uncomplimentary. Because last night I went up to the bar, wherever we were, and I asked for a gin and tonic for my wife. And they said, you can't have a glass, you have to buy a bottle. And I was stunned. But Isa came along and bought a bottle. So, if you see my wife lying under the table before the end of the night, don't blame me. Once again, blame Isa. Well, that's all I've got to say. I hope later on you'll invite me to sing. I especially look forward to singing with Richard from Hong Kong, not the one from KL, and of course Anthony and Katie, because they are splendid singers. We won't ask Alan Wong, because he's got a very deep voice. If you've spoken to him, you'll know that he's got a very deep voice. He sounds like, do you remember Lee Marvin?
I was born under a wandering star.
So, Alan, keep quiet, okay?
Thank you.
Andy, thank you so much, and thank you to the Penang community for making this possible. It really is wonderful. It just brought a slight tear to the eye, to be honest, when we arrived here tonight. It was very special, the amount of work that's gone in. But I think maybe my role is to obviously represent what the school is a little bit now, so that you can see that we are one. Because it's really easy to look at the past and look at the present and see them as different things. But it really isn't any different. The school, of course, physically has changed. Of course it has. You know, there are 570 students. We've got more girls than boys. That's just true. The food is edible. There are all sorts of, you know, innovations. But the key thing are the values. You know, the values that bind us together. When I joined the Concord community, it was, you know, 13 years ago, I became principal. And I was welcomed with a really open heart by all I met. And, you know, Mr. Morris is an extraordinary, extraordinary man who did an extraordinary job and has got an amazing spirit. And actually, following him, I was never going to be good enough. But actually, that was never, never said. It may have been thought, but it was never said. It was, no. But, you know, it's been that beautiful spirit which Concordians have. And it is still there today. Something I learned a little while into my time at Concord, which I share regularly with the students. And I was at a dinner last night with parents and alumni, younger alumni, in Singapore. We had a group together, a big group of about 200 people, and I've shared with them this thought, which I share with students now, of, and those of us who don't know Chinese will struggle with this, but those of you who know traditional Chinese, the word ting, to listen, is that right? Is that right? Listen, ting, listen. And if you think of the traditional character for that, it has the also the Chinese characters for the ear and for the eye and for the heart. And I think one of the really beautiful things at Concord in your time and now is that the school and the community teaches us all to see and hear more, because we represent such difference. There's so much difference in Concord that we have to do more than just listen. We've got to hear, most importantly, with our hearts. And that's what the school still represents today. It's those values which are number one. It's not the results. The results are great. And, you know, I am just as proud as Mr. Morris of the results that are achieved. But it's the values that matter most. Because to my mind, what values these young people today pass to their grandchildren matters the most. And, you know, in a world that's changing so fast, the values of friendship, of companionship, of treating others as you wish to be treated yourself, all of the things which we represent today as a group are still in Concord now. Anyway, that's enough from me.
Yes.
But thank you all for being here. Please come to 2019.
For such a wonderful speech, right? Give that a round of applause again, guys. Right, are you guys ready to start tonight?
Think so.
Yes.
Come on, no appetite, is it? You all want food, is it? Come on, are you guys ready to start tonight?
Yes.
All right. So, please be seated. We're gonna start the night right now.
Thank you.
see all of you enjoy the lion dance, okay? They don't eat humans. I don't know why they eat red packets. Okay? So, are you guys hungry?
Yes!
But before that, we have our first special performance by Mr. Daddy Leong. He's gonna play two songs.
Thank you.
before you proceed to take your food, there is a non-halal section. It's apparently is one of the halal section. So, if you are halal, please take your food. We have our upcoming performance. And they are Install Band!
Thank you.
guys have any song in mind, and if you guys see.
Everybody say good luck. Put your words Like the, somebody give me like the,
I mean.
stage. Let's give him a round of applause. Alright, so what we're gonna do? We're gonna sing you a happy birthday song and we're gonna wish you a happy birthday, alright? Are you guys ready? Insta!
Being cast on your wrist, but no other man. It's not
smile, a star can bring you near to me.
Oh, see you.